Hey there, is it Therapist Nomad here with another video on grief. In this episode, I want to tell you everything about having fun in Greece when you're on a budget. Nico and I were able to go to an island, do a road trip, and go to the beach for a very decent price. We did make some mistakes in the way, but I'll let you know all about it so you don't make those mistakes. But anyways, Athens can be a little bit expensive, probably at the moderate level compared to other European countries, but we noticed that depending on the area, some things get clearly more expensive. Anything right under the Acropolis will be expensive for sure. For example, you can find a gyro for about 12 euros around that area, but then if you go somewhere else or near the suburb area, you will find a gyro for like even 4 euros. The cost of food for two people is usually about 40 euros on average, and that includes two main courses and two drinks. It seems that tourists are expected to tip, though it's not required. Per my readings, a 5 to 10% tip is appreciated. Moreover, the supermarkets are more affordable. Nico and I would spend about 45 euros worth 2 to 3 days of food, which was pretty good, really amazing actually. And the food is super fresh and delicious. The taxis can be very expensive, so I truly recommend you to take a look at the public transportation. It's very easy to use and very affordable. Now, when it comes to the islands, going to Mykonos, for example, can go over 100 euros per person. And the ferry time can be about 7 hours, which is a whole day of work for us. You can find flights for about 100 euros, but that doesn't include check-in bags, which again complicates things for us. Besides that, we would have to return to Athens to catch another flight to our next destination. Therefore, due to financial and logistical reasons, we decided to go to Greece on a budget. So here are three cool things that you can do in Greece. First, let's start with a road trip. Starting with finances, we spent about $207 for the two of us for a whole day with a car, visiting two archaeological sites, and having lunch out. It took us about an hour and 45 minutes to get to Mycenae, and then from there we drove about 40 minutes to get to Epidaurus, and then we drove 2 hours to get back home. Hello everyone!
Hey there!
We got a rental car to get a little road trip that it's going to be like 2 hours away. And yeah, the car was how much?
55 euros.
55 euros.
Not bad.
Not bad. I'll put the name of the company and we're gonna have the car for 24 hours. So we're gonna get the most out of it. In the second millennium BC, Mycenae was one of the major centers of Greek civilization and military stronghold. It was known for having palatial states, urban organizations, works of art, and writing systems. If you come to visit, you will appreciate the remainings of what this site was, and some of the things that you would see is a treasure of Atreus, which are tombs situated in the Mycenae, and they're very well reserved. The subterranean cistern, religion center of Mycenae, Cyclopean walls, building complex of the oil merchant, the lion's gate, and the grave circle B. This is the tallest tomb of
Clytemnestra.
Clytemnestra. Where are you gonna go in? This is the Lion Gate, which is the main entrance to the citadel. Let's go.
That's
it? An animal. The gate used to be closed by a double door and secured with a sliding bar. It's dated circa 1240 BC. This is the propylon of a palace, meaning the entrance. And this is a view of a palace. And this, I guess, are the remainings of the palace. Most of the basements of the buildings that were built here are preserved, but the buildings itself are not. The constructions appear to be used around the 13th century, but they were destroyed by fire by the end of the century. Welcome to Epidavros. It's a little church up there in the hill, and we're gonna be eating at the Hotel Poseidon restaurant and then do some explorations around the city to see what's there to see. And guys, this is the Mediterranean Ocean. Ah, I love it. Hey guys, we are here in Epidauros in Greece. It's to the west side to Athens, and it's a city that was colonized by Penopolisea. And according to Greek mythology, this is the birthplace of Asclepius, the healing god. Another important fact about this city is that it's very famous by a huge theater that fits, do you remember the number?
18,000.
About 18,000 people, and the best part is that they still run special events and carnivals during the summer. We're gonna go there in a few minutes. We're getting some details about the history of the theater. It looks like the lower part has about
34
rows, and the upper part has about 20 rows. And then the theater can accommodate 12,000 spectators.
Its original form remained intact in the Roman times, during which most Greek theaters underwent major changes. Let's take a look.
Let's take a look. View. I wish we had a third person that could record who will get up there the fastest, but since we don't, we'll do it the boring way. Although I know I'm gonna win. I would win.
You know? Fastest?
The fastest.
Between me and you?
Between me and you. That's your fastest game? Oh my god, how embarrassing. This archaeological site is so important here in Greece because it represents one of the finest and best preserved examples of a classical Greek theater. Even by today's standards, this monument really stands out, so I truly recommend you visit it.
So this is the stadium, and the Epidaurian festival to honor Asclepios comprised of ceremonies and also athletic games like sprints. These are all the lanes, like a track. I guess they would do sprint competitions. And this was actually mentioned by Plato in his dialogue called Ion.
Nice. Warning, we made a massive mistake by taking a taxi to go to the beach. They charged us 30 euros and this was just a scam. It wasn't fair. Take the metro and you'll only spend about 8 euros for two people to travel the whole day. Before our beach adventure, we got ourselves some healthy smoothies in Plaka. The place is about a 6-minute walk from the Acropolis metro station on the main street of Plaka. They have delicious options for smoothies and juices and everything is super healthy, so this is definitely the perfect meal idea before the beach. We just arrived to the beach. I will put the name down below because we had plans to go to another beach, but the taxi driver told us that it was gonna be a little bit expensive. We had to pay at the entrance about like 40 euros to enter to the beach. And we were like, we don't wanna do that. We're just trying to have like a short afternoon at the beach. We're not gonna spend the whole day there. Like we actually have to go back home around 6 because we start work at 7 p.m. So we did not want to pay 40 euros for just a few hours at the beach. So he brought us to another beach that is free. Everything's free here. So it looks beautiful. And yeah. Okay guys, the time at the beach has been pretty amazing. The water though is so cold, but I love it. Guys, we are on a metro station, so our taxi driver wasn't the nicest. First of all, he charged us 30 euros to go like 12 minutes away. Second of all, he scammed us, he told us to get any bus to go back to the city, so that's what we did. We got any bus to get back to the city, and yeah, that bus did not take us to the city to the city of Athens, the center of Athens. It took us somewhere else, so now we're having to take a train, metro. This is the metro station of the Acropolis. We made it. Alright guys, we picked Aegina for an island trip just because it's very close to Athens and it's also pretty affordable. We chose to do this trip in the middle of a workday, so we had to make the most out of it. Hey guys, we are here at a ferry ready to go to an island called Aegina, which is about like 40 minutes away in a fast ferry and an hour and a half in the slow ferry, which is the one that we're taking. We're doing this in the middle of a work day, so we're gonna go to the island. It's about 12 p.m. and be back around 6 p.m. so we can start our work day at 7 p.m. We're super excited. We didn't think we were gonna do an island because we thought that it was super expensive. We were looking at Santorini and Mykonos. Just so you know, Santorini can be about like 7 hours away in the ferry, so we were like, oh, that's a whole day of work. If we go, we have to stay at least a few nights, so it was gonna be a lot of money that we were going to have to put in to do a quick trip to an island. So yeah, a taxi driver told us about this opportunity, so we're taking it, we're going. Aegina is an island in the Saronic Gulf south of Athens. It's one of the most popular islands because it's a quick getaway thanks to its proximity to Athens. The island offers a bunch of small beaches that are well organized with many facilities, restaurants, and cute little stores. If you want to go, we recommend you that you go to a store to get the ferry tickets. Don't get them online, just because the people at the store will let you know what are the paperwork that you need due to COVID, and they'll guide you on how to enter the island without any problems. It's a very easy process, and the ferry stores are just steps away from the ferries. Since we refused to take taxis again, we rented our own motorcycle to spend a day driving around and going to the places that we wanted to go. I truly recommend that you rent a motorcycle or a car if you come to an island, just because the taxis can be pretty expensive. I read from a blogger that to go around the island with a taxi driver to take you to an archaeological site, wait for you, and take you back to the city, it can cost you like over 30 euros. So we wanted to avoid that and make our own choices, feeling free to go, stay, and do whatever we wanted to do. So I'm going to try a traditional pie that it's made with pistachios that are local and some honey and
cream cheese
inside. We decided to be pretty adventurous and come to a private random beach in the middle of a road. Let me show you this. Oh god, sorry, I'm holding a bunch of stuff. This is going to be our beach. And since we have like 4 hours total, as I told you, it's already 2 o'clock. We have to be back at the port at 4:45. So we're timing everything. We have about like 30 minutes total to be at the beach. I mean, life cannot get better than this, guys. I am like in complete awe. In the meantime, here's this guy. Oh. Mind you, he could have taken the stairs, but yep. This beach experience was one of the best choices we made on this trip. We highly recommend you do something similar. The experience at the island has been so amazing. You have to do this. We're trying to do Greece on a budget because we want to get ready for the summer. We're planning to go to Italy in July. So we're like, okay, let's take it slow and lay low. So if you're coming to Greece on a budget, you have to come to this island. And let me show you why. We are right next to the archaeological site that we really want to see, but I mean, this beach view is just too much, too much. That's all I want to do right now, just be at the beach. This is the view of the archaeological site. It seems closed right now, but I'm just enjoying the fact that you can hang out next to history and next to nature. Isn't that epic? And this is the liquor. Guys, this is pistachio. Ooh, can you see it there? Maybe. Pistachio liquor. Do you like it?
Wow, it is really good.
Yeah?
Yeah. Oh man, I didn't know pistachio.
Pistachio butter.
It's such a good thing. It's like almond butter, almond.
It has other ingredients as well. We also have pistachio paste, which is 100% pistachio.
Oh my god.
You like it?
It's amazing.
Isn't it crazy?
Try our pralines as well.
It tastes like baklava.
Do you want to taste our baklava?
Yeah, we should get some baklavas.
You want to bring baklavas too? I already bought the bars.
Well, I guess we got to take an hour boat ride.
Yeah. So. Isn't it delicious?
Everything's so good.
Okay.
Ooh. Mm. Wow.
Good? To die for.
Mm.
Delicious.
To die for.
Flying dolphin. Pretty fast.
The flying dolphin is way faster than the regular ferry, and it feels like you're inside of an airplane. If you ask, I would say that my favorite experience was at the island. That is a day I will never ever forget. And if you have been to an island in Greece, I'm sure you can relate. I hope you enjoyed this video. I know we made some mistakes in the way and we could have saved up some money here and there, but this is our honest experience. If you have some feedback, feel free to share. And if you liked the video, don't forget to like and subscribe, and see you next time.